The question is, why Minhaj al-Quran celebrates Christmas and why Sheikh al-Islam have attended some of the programs organized by
Minhaj al-Quran.
Yes, Minhaj al-Quran and Minhaj al-Quran's center. This is first. And the second question, which is kind of together, is at this London Peace, the Peace for Humanity conference, when all the leaders
one
of the...
By one. One verse, okay. Answer first question,
sure.
Then ask the second one.
Exactly.
That why not only Minhaj al-Quran, or I would make it more broader, can Muslims participate in any gathering or they can organize, for example, Christmas? Is it permissible for them or not? And in many years, it has been organized for the Christian minority people in Pakistan, the Christmas program, and they were invited and they celebrated here in Minhaj al-Quran International Center in Lahore. So the question of its permissibility. Answer is very simple and categorical. There are certain things between different religions. I mean our religion, Islam and Christianity or Judaism or other religions. Every act practiced by other religions is not an act of difference or dispute with us. There are similarities and there are dissimilarities. Between different religions, there are some commonalities and some different, totally different aspects in Aqidah and practice. As far as the Christmas celebration is concerned, there is absolutely no harm in celebrating Christmas. Answer, whether it is permissible or not, answer is yes, categorically yes. What is Christmas? Christmas is just celebration of birthday of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. It has nothing to do with their other aspect of Aqidah regarding their Aqidah of Godship or being son, accepting him, Isa alayhi salam, son of God, accepting him, God, accepting, regarding their Aqidah of Trinity or regarding their cross or crucifixion. Christmas has nothing to do with all of these acts. Here lies our dissimilarity and difference. Christmas is just celebration of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. And celebration of the birthday of a prophet is permissible in Islam. And we also believe in prophethood and messengership of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. They may have any kind of aqidah regarding Jesus Christ. But the occasion of Christmas is just a celebration of his birthday. And this is acceptable for Muslims in a way that it establishes the aqidah of Tawheed, and celebration of Christmas establishes the negation of his being God or Son of God. Because the one who is born is always humble servant of God. The one who is born is the creation of God. He can never be a God. The one who is born, he can never be a God. So as far as the Christmas is concerned, only I am talking of just one this aspect. This is permissible to us. This is Mawlid. As we celebrate Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, and we can celebrate Mawlid of Sayyidina Abu Bakr. If you want, there are so many mawlids. If you want to celebrate thousands, mawlid of Sayyidina Umar, mawlid of Sayyidina Ali, mawlid of Sayyidina Imam Hassan and Hussein, you can celebrate mawlid of Sayyida Fatima, you can celebrate mawlid of Sayyidina Rasulullah Shaykh Abdul Qadir al-Jilani, you can celebrate mawlid of Sayyidina Imam al-Shazidi, you can celebrate mawlid of Imam al-Rifai, you can celebrate your own mawlid birthday. Celebration of mawlid is permissible in Islam. That's why we celebrate Mawlidun Nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the birthday of Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. If we can celebrate the Mawlid of Awliya, so why can we not celebrate the Mawlid of Anbiya, Mawlid of Prophets? If we want, we can celebrate. If there was any group celebrating Mawlid of Sayyidina Musa, it was no harm in celebrating it. If anybody wants to celebrate Mawlid of Ibrahim alayhis salam, no harm in celebrating it. If anybody wants to celebrate Mawlid of Sayyidina Zakariya, Sayyidina Yahya, Sayyidina Nuh, all Mawlid celebrations are permissible. So I would like to give you two examples, very interesting for you, and it will enhance your knowledge and understanding of deen. You know the reality of Jum'ah. This is our Yawmul Eid, Jum'ah, the Friday. This Friday, Yawmul Eid, is in fact the celebration of the birth of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam. When the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was asked about the Friday, he said, Fiha khuliqa Adam. This is the day when Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam was created. So his birth took place in the form of creation. He had no father and mother. So we don't use the word birth, but this was his creation day. And Holy Prophet said, send durood, salutations on me on Friday, because this is the birthday of Adam alayhi salam. So it is recommended to the Ummah, for the Ummah of Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the celebration of the birthday, I would say creation day of Sayyidina Adam alayhi salam, in the form of Jummah. It will continue to the day of judgment. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam gave us another example. Another example. It comes in Sahih Bukhari and Sahih Muslim, muttafaq alayh. When Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam migrated to Medina, he found the Jews of Medina and Khaybar, the Jews, they used to celebrate the 10th day of Muharram as the day of victory of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam, victory of Moses. This was their celebration day, 10th of Muharram. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked them, that why do you celebrate this day specifically, 10th of Muharram? He asked them, Holy Prophet asked, why are you celebrating this day as Yawmul Eid? They replied, we consider this day of 10th of Muharram as the day of victory of Sayyidina Musa, Moses, against Fir'aun. That's why we celebrate it as Eid. Holy Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they used to fast that day. The Jews, Holy Prophet fast, Jews used to fast that day. This was the mode of their celebration in those days. Holy Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam commanded the companions, and he said that nahnu ahqqu bi Musa minhum. If they celebrate the victory day of Moses, we have much more right of Sayyidina Musa alaihi wasallam than they have. So he commanded his companion, you should also celebrate this day by fasting. So this became Sunnah, the fasting of 10th day. Then next year he added one more day to it, and fasting of 9th and 10th of Muharram. So the origin of fasting of 9th and 10th is the celebration of the victory day of Sayyidina Musa alayhi salam. So anything in which the basic theme on which that is based is not contradictory to our faith, and that is related to any prophet and messenger of God. So we also believe Sayyidina Musa, Sayyidina Isa, all prophets. We believe, we have faith in all prophets and messengers. So according to Holy Prophet, nahnu ahqqu bi Musa minhum. I say, nahnu ahqqu bi Isa minhum. We have much higher right in celebrating the birthday of Sayyidina Isa than anybody else in this world. Because he is the prophet. He is the prophet who gave the good tidings of the raising of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam to the mankind, when he said, "Inni mubashshiran bi rasulin ya'ti min ba'di ismihi Ahmad." He was the one who announced before the mankind that I am here to give you good news and good tidings that soon after me, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wa sallam is going to be raised in the world. So it is a good sign if we celebrate Christmas. Christmas is just the celebration of the birthday of Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam. But we are not allowed to celebrate other events in which they are based, those events which they are based on their own wrong aqeedah, which we do not agree with them. For example, crucifixion and in March or April, whatever. What is this, Easter? We can't celebrate Easter. Here lies the contradiction or conflict between both aqeedahs. But just Christmas, since it is confined to the birthday celebration of Sayyidina Isa. So if we want to do, you can do. It's permissible, no harm in it. And Sayyidina Isa al-Islam, Jesus Christ, is the only prophet and messenger of God. Almighty Allah has mentioned his birth, his story of his birth at length. No other prophet's story of birth has been mentioned in such length. And Quran has celebrated his birthday, Sayyidina Isa al-Islam. The last word, Holy Quran has celebrated, saying in this word in Surah Maryam, Salamun alayhi yawma. Another said, وَسَلَامٌ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّةٌ سَلَامٌ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيَّةٌ Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam says, that salutation and peace be on me on the day when I was born, and when I will die, and when I would be raised before the day of judgment. So Quran says the salutations on Sayyidina Isa alayhi salam on his birthday. This is celebration of birthday of Sayyidina Isa, Jesus Christ. So this is according to the commandment of Quran. This is the point of commonality and similarity. There is no problem in this. Somebody has asked, for example, they drink alcohol or dance. This is when they do their own activity. Don't go there, where haram things are being committed. But if you invite them, so you will never serve any alcohol or dance or any haram thing. You will just cut a cake, or you will recite Holy Quran, or you will sing the good songs, the praise and nasheed. So do as permissible in Islam according to the Holy Prophet's teachings. This was the first question. What is your second question? So keep in your mind that Holy Prophet ordered, commanded the companions to celebrate the day of Sayyidina Musa as the Jews used to celebrate. In the same way, it comes in Bukhari and Muslim. And Sayyidina Isa, I quoted you the word Salamun alayya yawma wulidtu. So celebrating the birthday of Sayyidina Isa is commanded by Holy Quran. Yes.